Matters such as women's status in society, their importance to family life, and whether or not they should work have been important subjects of debate all over the world for many years. Yet for a Muslim, women's place in society is crystal clear, because Islam states that men and women are fully equal. According to Islamic moral values, what matters is not whether someone is a man or a woman, but their devotion to God with a deep faith and awed fear, and their striving to abide by the moral values of the Quran. It is these characteristics of people that will be appreciated in the sight of God. For women who abide by Quranic moral values, the question is not one of striving for equality with men, but in competing to commit auspicious deeds. Such competition shows that believers spend their lives doing all in their power to obtain God's approval. In the Quran, God reveals that it is these endeavors that will bring people to the fore in this world and the next. Such people are truly racing toward good things, and they are the first to reach them. In the Quran, God emphasizes the importance of good behavior displayed towards mothers. Parents do their best to give their children a good education, a decent character, and teach them to act properly. A person must have respect for this altruism and appreciate the efforts made on his or her behalf. God advises people not to forget their parents' selfless devotion to them and to treat them equally well. Your Lord has decreed that you should worship none but Him and that you should show kindness to your parents. Whether one or both of them reach an old age with you, do not say "Ugh" to them out of irritation, and do not be harsh with them. Rather, speak to them with gentleness and generosity. Take them under your wing, out of mercy, with due humility, and say, "O Lord, show mercy to them as they did in looking after me when I was small." It is a person's faith and fear of God that beautifies and strengthens their character and that makes them superior. As they do for all people, the moral values of the Quran bestow the strongest, healthiest, and most beautiful characteristics on women. Muslim women believe in God with a true heart, submit completely to Him, are aware that there is no other deity, that He is the Lord of every being and thing, and that He is all-powerful. God gives good news to those who submit to Him. Not so. All those who submit themselves completely to God and are good doers will find their reward with their Lord. They will feel no fear and will know no sorrow. Since they take the Quran as their guide, Muslim women always behave in the correct manner, take wise decisions, and therefore obtain the best results in all they do. They live far removed from the stresses and troubles inflicted on women by irreligion. Immaturity and a failure to behave rationally and reasonably when the right thing conflicts with one's own desires are forms of behavior that humiliate one. The fact is, however, that the noble and best thing to do against the evil insinuations of one's earthly desires is to guard against them and follow one's conscience. Muslim women have the dignity and character to reject such debasing behavior for small gains. God draws attention to this powerful, immovable, and honorable character in the Quran. O you who believe, if any of you renounce your religion, God will bring forward a people whom He loves and who love Him. Humble to the believers, fierce to the unbelievers, who strive in the way of God and do not fear the blame of any censurer. That is the unbounded favor of God, which He gives to whoever He wills. God is boundless, all-knowing. Unbelievers think that being emotional is an important part of the human character. According to this view, the resulting behavior is a feeling that needs to be experienced. Such behavioral defects as being angry, upset, and introverted, or weeping, complaining, and apathy are encouraged, for they supposedly come from the heart. This view is completely wrong. Muslim women know the selfish ego's qualities and how to fight them, for their personalities and lives are defined by the Quran. Muslim women guard themselves against all such behavioral defects out of their strong love and fear of God. God has made Maryam a role model for all subsequent generations. God has chosen you and purified you. He has chosen you over all other women. God reveals the perfect character of a Muslim woman in that of Maryam. All the moral attributes for which men are held responsible in the ideal Muslim character described in the Quran also apply to women. Everyone, be they man or woman, must be devoted to God with a sincere love. They must live in a manner that will be pleasing to our Lord, holding Him above all things. Everyone who lives by such a sincere faith will, by the will of God, enjoy the greatest reward in His sight. Men and women who are Muslims, men and women who are believers, men and women who are obedient, men and women who are truthful, men and women who are steadfast, men and women who are humble, men and women who give alms, men and women who fast, men and women who guard their chastity, men and women who remember God much. God has prepared forgiveness for them and an immense reward.